Well, hello there. This is Shane from Shane's Books and Review, and I hope that you are having a great day today. Today we're going to be talking about something a little bit less serious than some of the other books that we've covered here lately. So this is going to be number one in customer service, wrote by Larry Correa, narrated by Adam Baldwin. Yeah, we'll just go from there. This audiobook is laid out in a way that I've not really seen others before. It's actually clever. There's your opening credits from Audible and all that kind of stuff, and then you get into the author introduction, and then because this is a collection, instead of it being broke up in actual files, like let's say the Stephen Fry reading of Sherlock Holmes or something like that, what they've done is they've broke it out with the chapters. Awesome. Thank you. Finally. It makes sense. The long of it all is the chapter 3, quote unquote, is actually the adventure of Tom Stranger, interdimensional insurance agent. And it's the entire book. And then there's The Murder of Manatees, Further Adventures, which was the second book. And then there's The New Stuff, which we will talk about. So Donut Run, Apocalypse Cow, and The Custies. And then the end credits. So Donut Run is a fun little story where there is a evil dolphin, because I mean let's face it, the dolphins still haven't gotten over being slighted in book one. Yeah, they're butt heads, especially this one that comes into their office and thinks that he's going to shake things up and cause problems for Jimmy, the intern, the forever intern. In between jokes about random drug tests and as long as a particular character in that book receives the donut that he wants, maybe we can skip over those tests. You know, these sorts of things. So there's all kinds of knowing fourth wall-ish kind of comedy that happens. I don't want to use fourth wall as a standard because it's not. It's only broke every so often. But just knowing what it is and the comedy that's there, it's well worth the read. And as I was saying in the video before I recorded this one, and if nobody's read Tom Stranger interdimensional stuff before, this would be an excellent gift to them if they like zany sci-fi and paradoxical type things that are actually fun and funny. I don't really think you could go wrong. So if you could find a copy of it, pass it along. Also, a longer story called Apocalypse Cow, which that one is very interesting because poor Jimmy has an issue. It's usually Jimmy that's causing the issues in these books. He tries to get Tom Stranger to help, but he can't because of the rules of interdimensional insurance, and he will not break those rules because rules are rules. Phenomenally well done and quite funny throughout. We end up meeting an older version of Jimmy, which is all grizzled. There's a toughness scale that's used in here where the people are rated on a Bear Grylls scale. So how many Bear Grylls do you make up in your survivability? Jimmy doesn't even rate a whole Bear Grylls. He's like 0.4. He's not even 50%, but the older version of him is like 27 or 28 Bear Grylls. So he's developed. He's got some skills now. But as the book said, unfortunately, due to learning Kung Fu fighting against cows that are slow moving creatures, he's not that fast. But I mean, it's that kind of stuff all the way through it, and it's very aware. That's part of the thing that's so refreshing about it. It's not on the woke PC culture train or anything like that either, which is very, very refreshing. I know one day that's going to bleed into books, and it's going to be a sad day. So in short, some of the feelings that book brought out of me was laughter, enjoyment. It was a fun read. It was nice. Because of, you know, the way that everything was handled within these different stories and such, I mean, nothing has been cut off. He can continue to write about it, and I would be very happy if he did, because it's such an enjoyable thing. It's a decent story, kind of uplifting and sometimes mildly touching to the heart whenever you realize what the base of what's being said is said. As far as the next book goes, I know this video will probably be fairly short. I'm sure Zach will be appreciative of that, especially after the last two books that I've reviewed, where I went on and on and on incessantly. So I've got All the Rage by F. Paul Wilson, which is the third book in the Repairman Jack saga. Crooked River, wrote by Douglas Preston and Lincoln Child, which is the latest Pendergast story. Multitude by Dean M. Cole. Terminus by Peter Kleins. Measures of Absolution by Marco Close. So, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. If you made it this far, you are a very nice person indeed. And thank you so much for staying color coordinated. It is so appreciated. Beyond that, though, YouTube wants you to see one of these books over here. I'm not sure which one you'll pick. If you pick that one, that would be so very cool. This is Shane with Shane's Books and Review. Like, share, subscribe. And I will see you and you and you in the next video.